Now we will continue with Katrin Marx-Jaskulski. She's an archivist and director of the Central Department of Civil Refugees and a Land Refugees Archives at the National Museum of Archives.
Thank you very much for the kind introduction. This morning I presented civil registers since 1874 and their precursors, for example, Jewish registers. In the following, I will concentrate on the registers which were held in the civil registry offices established 1874 in Prussia and 1876 in the German Empire. For the first time, civil registration of vital events did not depend on religious denomination. There's a main register and a duplicate in order to have sort of a backup copy in case of the destruction of the main register. According to legal requirements, the contemporary copies of civil registers of all Hessian communities are kept in the Hessian Archives for Civil Registers. In order to meet the commitments of data protection, a timeline for opening them to public was established. Since 2009, the records are accessible after these time periods have passed. Birth registers, 110 years, marriage registers, 80 years, death registers, 30 years. About the amount. The Personenstandsarchiv, the Hessian Archives for Civil Registers, keeps 130,000 contemporary duplicates of the registers in about 1,500 shelf meters. The main registers, so-called Hauptregister, are archived in the communities. Additionally, to the entries in the main register, so-called Sammelakten, files where additional documents are put together, had been set up. They contain, for example, birth certificates of the engaged couple or notices of death, certificates of adoption, and so on. The registers contain main personal data, names, dates, and places of civil status cases. And not only of the newborn child, bride and groom, or the decedent. Of course, you have place, date, and time of birth or of the death, the child's name and his or her sex, name, religion, age, occupation, and residence of the engaged couple or the decedent. But additionally, you have information about the person announcing the event at the civil registry office, the one who goes to the civil registry office to say that a child has been born. In the most cases, it's the father, then bride and groom, and other family members or a physician who reports the death of a person. You also have information about the parents, also in death registers, or of the witnesses to a marriage. The information recorded in the records varies slightly over time. For example, between 1938 and 1958, death registers contain causes of death, what makes them very interesting for historical statistical research. But in the first place, the registers are very important for genealogical research, of course. The physical structure. We have hardback books or brochures, mainly in smaller municipalities, and we classified them along civil registry office in alphabetical order, type of register, and year. Sometimes a number of years have been bound together in one book for conservational reasons. As you see in this example here, it's the civil registry office of Besser, and they put those small brochures together from the years 1918 to 1924. But in most cases, we have one book per year, or in large cities, we have two or three volumes per year. You have a printed form. Those books were provided by a specific publisher. You have always a printed form and handwritten entries. In the form, there were specific spaces for the name, denomination, sex, age, residence, and so on. But what you have to consider, what is very important, is this broad margin on the office sheets. And there you find the very important marginal notes. Marginal notes can change or complete an entry. In this example, we have a marginal note about the divorce of a marriage, and here about the death of the first marital partner, which means that the marriage has an end here. This is an example for the completion of an entry. It's a birth register from the year 1876, and you see that in February a birth of a child was announced, but it hasn't had a name so far. Okay. And nearly 2 months later, the father reports that this child has got the name Adam Kilian. You have to consider these marginal notes. Another marginal notes are the so-called Hinweise hints, but they just point to entries in other registers. Here we have an example of the note of death in a birth entry. Sometimes the marginal notes are pasted into the register, which has to be considered in the digitization process. You have to capture the page 2 times. Birth, marriages, and death were written in the civil registration records as they occurred, and thus they are arranged chronologically. Where available, alphabetical indexes can help to find a person more easily. The indexes usually cover 1 year at a time and are located at the beginning or end of each year. In large cities, we have separate volumes. One short remark about metadata and digitization. Arkinsis, the online finding aid of the Hessian State Archives, offers access to the registers and their digital copies. The civil registers can be found in the collections until 926. Each collection covers a county or one of the large cities in Hesse: Frankfurt, Wiesbaden, Kassel, Offenbach, or Darmstadt. After clicking on the navigator option on the right, a list of all civil registry offices in this county opens. We listed the civil registry offices as they existed in history in alphabetical order. Some of them have been incorporated in other communities nowadays. By clicking on the little plus sign on the left of the civil registry office concerned, you can choose the type of register: birth, marriage, or death. And here you see the metadata for each register: civil registry office, type of register, and the year or the years. When you choose the register and you click Detailseite on the right, a thumbnail of the digital copy is visible. By clicking on the thumbnail, the digital copy gets provided via the DFG viewer, which offers comfortable browsing functions. The digitization of the registers, the images were captured from 2011 until 2014 by FamilySearch. Altogether, they captured 11.5 million images. The necessary preparations for their availability on the internet are in progress. Necessary preparations means we have to check the birth and marriage registers if there is information about children, name and date of birth, and if the protective period has expired yet. If not, we have to protect the image. We do not show it on the internet, but until January 2016, nearly 8.7 million images have been made available online. Thank you.
Thank you very much. There is a question.
I was surprised to see that in your database, the type of entry is not a separate field. Marriage, death. So how are you searching for them?
You have a register for each type of register. So that you know you have a marriage register book, and when you open it, you only have marriage entries in it. You have specific volumes for each type of register. That's how you separate them. Did I understand your question correctly?
I'm not sure. Can you go back? You have in one field, the first time you have... Oh, this is... Okay.
You have to choose the type of register one step before. You have to click on birth register, marriage register, or death register. And then a list of this type of register opens.
Yeah, but one day you will want to search for a certain person, will want to find all types of documents related to this person, wouldn't you?
Yeah, of course.
So if you don't have a special field for this, you won't be able to do that.
You mean in an indexing project that you...
Yeah,
okay. That's something we have to consider there.
I have a question concerning... Maybe we go back because you already put there something. The marginalia, you said that the marginalia are very important. How many of them probably can be found?
That depends on the civil registry office. But we have civil registry offices where you can find them in nearly every image.
Nearly every image. And the registries, they were written by the civil servants.
Mm-hmm.
So the writing is goes at least over several years, usually.
Yeah.
And the forms are rather stable over the years.
Mm-hmm.
Also, it probably will change.
You always have a form. You always have a fixed spaces for the information.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. So, from the layout analysis, that's not a big issue.
Mm-hmm.
To find the name or whatever is usual. I also have seen that the names are sometimes written in Latin, whereas the rest is current.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and a big, larger probably.
Mm-hmm. But not in each civil registry office.
Yeah.
It depends very much on the one who did the writing. Yeah.
But maybe the HDR people would say something on this. Just it's a very clear writing, professional writers, so it's not something can be done, especially for searching.
Mm-hmm.
If more data are needed, like date of birth or the things which are repeated, again, a lexicon will help very much, a database will help very much in the background, and that's also doable. And concerning the marginal notes, I mean, if this is unstructured text, then it's more complicated, but to find the marginal note as an item, and to say this record has a marginal note, that's clear.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that can be done.
I think we have such examples here. Yeah. So this is just enhancement. This is standardization. And actually, this is the layout analysis. This is the tool from a Transcriptorium project. So it's as we take it. The three regions, which are paragraphs. And you can see that even the text line is almost correct, even though we have a mixed type of text here. So this was not the case of Transcriptorium, but it seems to work. Okay, this is a zoom, just to see the quality of the text line detection. Also here it's a word detection result. Again here, okay, it's a layout analysis result. As you can see, this is paragraph. And this text is classified as marginalia. So this is the case you mentioned. It's already it's done just with the tools we have. And I think I haven't... Okay, this is an example of this marginalia, how it's analyzed the text lines. So you can see it's not many mistakes here. So I think it's we have a good input for the HDR. Okay, that's all.
Other questions or additions?
Yeah, maybe some additions. I work a lot with these civil records. I think maybe 10% have those long marginal notes. Those are important. The hints are not so much important because they are just redundant links to other other documents, maybe from the same town, from a different town. So they're not that important. And for the number of different handwritings, in larger cities you have sometimes 10 or 20 different persons working on these registers. Mm-hmm. So there are different handwritings. Maybe every page has a different handwriting, just depending on the person who wrote, mm-hmm. Who recorded this birth.
Mm-hmm. If you have several writers, then you will need more training data, but no problem of recognizing this.
Okay. Just a comment on the previous statement about the value of the hints. I think there are several good opportunities to use hints as opportunities for co-reference or reconstitution, or even for data validation if you think you will find similar name shapes in two completely separate documents. So the HintVisor can be a nice opportunity to find the same or similar personas or people in different documents. I think for recognition that could be helpful, and it could also be helpful to guide humans easily from one document to another without forcing them to search on their own. So that can be helpful as well. I would like to add as a second comment that handwriting recognition need not be perfect in order to be helpful. So a system that is, say, only 70% accurate, for example, especially if such a system could be tuned to precision over recall, could help people to get to documents that they would not find otherwise because they are not indexed. And then once they're there, if they confirm that this is in fact their person of interest, maybe then they can review an algorithmic transcription and correct it as part of the use process so that an index can be created or improved at the pace of research during the research process. But this doesn't require a 90% accurate transcription or a 100% accurate transcription. So many good things can be built on an okay system, on a mediocre system, I would say.
Thank you for your comments.